Hey guys, my name is Richie, and today I'm going to be reviewing The Walking Dead Season 3, Episode 10. Before I start, I just want to tell you guys that this episode is just freaking amazing! In this episode, Rick finally decides to tell someone that he's seeing things, that person being Herschel. So Rick tells Herschel that he's been seeing Lori and Shane, and, you know, of course, Herschel's just like, you know, he probably needs some sleep because he really hasn't been sleeping. He's been, like, going crazy since Lori died, and he just really hasn't slept. He's just overprotective, or he's still, woo, losing it. In this episode, you also learn some interesting information about Daryl's past and Merle's past, and one of the things that stood out the most about their past was that Daryl and Merle, they were planning to, like, rob the camp. If you guys don't know what camp I'm talking about, I'm talking about Shane's camp. Remember from, like, season one? Well, they were planning to rob them and, I guess, just, like, leave. So I was like, wow, you know, it's like, I didn't really think Daryl was going to do that. I don't really see Daryl as that kind of person. But then again, Daryl did change throughout the seasons because he's more of a, like, a leader now. He's not just, like, a follower. He's kind of, like, second in command, you know, behind Rick. I was just like, what? I didn't really imagine Daryl doing something like that. You know, I could see Merle doing something like that, but Daryl, I was just like,
no, it's impossible.
Now I'm just gonna fast forward towards the end because the ending is probably the best part of this episode, besides learning more information about Daryl and Merle's past. I mean, that was probably the most interesting part besides the ending. But yeah, the ending was just epic. It was badass. It was amazing. And it just made me hate the governor more. So the governor finally decided to attack the prison and hell just breaks loose. So this epic battle first started off with Carol talking to one of the remaining prisoners from the prison. I forgot his name. I think his name is Axel. He's like a white guy. He has like a weird mustache and his little goatee. I'm pretty sure it was Axel. I'm not really sure. So please don't attack me in the comments below. So yeah, I think his name is Axel. I'm pretty sure it's Axel. I'm like 80% sure it's Axel. So Carol and Axel were talking, and then suddenly someone shoots Axel in the head, and boom! And I was like, then hell breaks loose, as I mentioned before. They start firing at each other, and Rick's like outside the cage, or outside the prison, I should say, like around the fence, like outside the fence, and he's getting shot at, and he falls on the floor. It's just, it's crazy. You see gunfire, like, bah, 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 and it's just, it's crazy. In Rick's group, there was only one casualty, and that casualty was Axel. But yeah, this episode was just freaking amazing, badass. But the episode didn't really start off really strong. It was kind of weak. I'm going to rate this episode a 9 out of 10. Alright guys, so I wanted to ask you guys, like, what are your thoughts about episode 10? Did you guys like it? Did you guys hate it? Are you guys excited that Merle and Daryl are back at the prison? Or let me know your predictions about episode 11. So let me know in the comments below. And thanks for watching. So bye.